मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर श्रीकांत, वी कंटिन्यूइंग द साधना सीरीज लेक्चर्स. लास्ट लेक्चर टेकन बाय डॉक्टर मनीष एंड दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन पार्ट ऑफ दैट लास्ट लेक्चर. फ्रेंड्स, बिफोर वी बिगिन, टुमारो इज गुरु पूर्णिमा, सो लेट्स प्रे टुगेदर फॉर आवर मास्टर डॉक्टर सैंडल कनन, आवर गुरु डॉक्टर अतुल विजयकर सर एंड ऑल माइटी, सो दैट स्टार्ट द टुडेज डिस्कशन विद द प्रेयर. गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. लेट्स बिगिन टुडे. इन साधन से एकदम द प्राइमेटिक मेडिकल विच इज देयर डूइंग देयर कवर्सन टू ऑफ मटर मेडिकल. नाउ डॉक्टर अतुल विजयकर सर हैज मेंशन्ड दिस प्राइमेटिक मटर. Now, what is prime arithmetic? That is easier. First, we attribute master. He's always in a state of humanity. He never attributed anything for himself. My guru, Dr. Vijayakar sir, the son of Maudati, who limited the path of healing for the whole humanity. Now, beginning the lecture, prime arithmetic number. What is prime arithmetic mathematical? And why sir has mentioned this is a prime arithmetic mathematical? That is very important for us. The prime arithmetic mathematical, where we have a three Maya terms, Sura, Psychosis, and Syphilis. And with that, we understand the drugs or the remedies which is born on the healthy human being. Why you have to understand in this way, or this is a better way, that we will learn today or understand. This is that when you understand any mathematics, any remedy with this thing, so you will not miss out the thing of that remedy and you will not bias with the remedies. That is the most important thing in the prime arithmetic mathematics. Let's understand what is the prime arithmetic mathematics and why we should describe it. Yeah. If you go and understand the reverse repertory, we have every remedy in the rubrics according to the manipulation. And we differentiated that and we study the reverse remedy. That reverse remedy will give the understanding of these remedies or this drug has this component or these rubrics also. Okay. So the what aspect of that drug we are able to understand. Now what is the use of this? There are different ways of studying the remedy. Like people are studying the genomes, people are studying the thematic mathematical, and third is the symptoms, and fourth are psychosis, Sura psychosis, and syphilis. This is the three ways where we can continue understanding the remedy. For understanding a prime arithmetic, first review a prescription. This is very important for the prescription. Second is a potency selection, and third it is a complete mathematical picture of the remedy. Now we have to understand what is by a doctor. This is mentioned by our master Kannan also in appointment number 11. Why we have to study this in particular this way? In Organum of Medicine, Dr. Hanuman has mentioned in Aphorism of the Legend, when a person falls sick, it is only the spiritual self-acting vital force everywhere present in the organism that is primarily managed by the dynamic influence upon it of morbific agent which is inimical to the living. It is only the vital force managed in such an abnormal state that can furnish the organism with its disagreeable sensations and comfort. So, for us to understand, only make itself known by the manifestation of the disease in the sensation and the function of the parts of the organism exposed to the senses of observer and the physician, that is by the morbid symptom, and in another way, can it make itself known. Dr. Hamilton has told in his algorithm
that we should understand so what is the sign and symptoms.
And this can be understood only by the manifestation of the disease. Now, how will we understand the manifestation of the disease? Manifestation of the disease is understood by the sensation and the function. That means we will understand this by the symptoms. Now, the symptoms which is taken by the proving, while taking in the proving, is converted into the rubrics and then it is under the, it come under the repertorization.
Okay, so when you understand this, so that's why a triangulation is very important for the prescription.
So you will get all sensations, all function which has caused derangement of the vital or which is the outward picture of the vital. So during the prescription, if you have an understanding of the triangulation of the vital, we will not able to miss out the symptoms. Second, a potency selection. Why it is important in the potency selection also? Because in the potency selection, if the case is a psoriatic dominance, psychotic dominance, or syphilitic dominance, it is
now as Vijayendra sir also mentioned us to in the psoriatic cases we have to go a 200 or 1 mL according to the case. In the psychotic cases, 200 potency. In the syphilitic cases, which is more deranged, there we can give a lower potencies and to see the changes. That's why in the potency selection also, it is very important. And third thing, to learn the complete miasmatic picture of the remedy. Now, this is a basic thing where we will understand the broad, broader aspect of the Matra Medica. Let's begin. Let's continue this triangulation Matra Medica understanding with some cases. So this is the cases where we will understand how the this is the acute case which coming to the clinic. A baby of 1.5-year-old child is 14-minute 20-21 case. A high grade fever of 103, fever every 4 to 5 hours. After giving double dose of paracetamol, temperatures come for 2 to 3 hours and then rise back again. Mild cold and cough. Chandra's appetite is diminished. Thermal hot. Thirst no change. Perspiration only after paracetamol. Sleep no change. Irritable while she is forced to eat. This is the symptom. On this, we have gone an observation. Child is playful once fevers come down. She is talkative during the fever spike and a febrile state also. Playful, happy child, allowed to examine me. So on this basis, family history on that time, the both in the family is having the actually viral fever, cold pruritus since last 2 days. So in totality, we have taken loquacity hit during high grade fever, continued fever and hot. A medicine has prescribed loquacity 1 mL. As it is acute case, so after 12 hours fever has given a gap to for next 24 hours. Okay, then in follow on after 24 hours the fever came again, and once the fever has came again the patient's appetite has diminished. Observation, not much change in activity of the patient.
She is still talkative and active. Understanding lachesis, after 1 mL dose of lachesis, baby is better for 12 hours and then fever continue, no improvement in appetite. That is, every person the basic things has to be started. As sir has mentioned, when you give the right remedy, the first psoriatic symptom has to be better, like sleep, appetite, that has to be improved. In this case, this is not happening. So medicine has acted superficially and taken care of only fever for the shorter period. Conclusion, remedy is partially similar. Again, we have reviewed the case. A father says when we check her temperature, then only we know that she is having fever or else she is active in 103 fever. She didn't tell anything. What is she doing during the fever? The question is asked and they are saying she is playing and doing her own thing. Parents are now worried because fever is continuing since last 3 days.
Now repertorization, again we go and repertorize this case, and this repertorization it is in cheerful, happy, hybrid cure and continued cure. From SIRS acute charge also, no change in activity and never complaints. Confirmation, the father has said in heavy state also. Now in fever also, we have to take care of a lot of when she is sleeping, because the slight noise like someone comes to the home or the younger brother is crying, then she wake up immediately, and if deep sleep also, and immediately start playing. For this, we have prescribed opium balance, and after medicine, there is no fever in next 24 hours. The first basic thing, the patient's appetite has improved and she is better. Now this is the case where we understand is how a opium has acted and what is the structure. In the first time what we have done, we have taken the symptoms, we have prescribed the medicine, but that medicine is partially correct because it is only taken care of the fever. But when we go and understand deeply, like Dr. Hanuman has always mentioned us, that sound senses and observation and attentiveness while taking the case and understanding the patient is very important. So when you go on this and we take the whole picture, as Dr. Hanuman has mentioned, and the patient will be better within a 24 hour, even if hybrid fever since last 24, 3 days and continue fever. After that, she is absolutely fine and no complaint. Let's go for the another case. This is the case which I have taken on the phone case. Mrs. SK, 42 years, is a case from Pune. She had called me fever every 8 hours since 2 to 3 days. Temperature goes to 1.1 to 1.3 degree Fahrenheit. Patient was taking paracetamol, generalized weakness since 2 to 3 days, followed by cough and heaviness feeling in the chest. Cough was dry initially and then expectoration started. Expectoration is missing, yellowish color and no taste. General hot, restless, RX. On this basis, on phone case, we will prescribe the pulsatile of one dose. But after this, her saturation is 90, heart rate is 106 and BP is normal. Clinical finding amount 27.6, we advise to do the CBC. HB is 10.4, total count has reduced to 2700, neutrophil 16, lymphocyte is 36. This report is done on the same day of first given. After 12 hours of medicine, fever is little. Patient doctor said she is doing okay. After 24 hours, fever again started and patient is not feeling good. Because of this phone case, we have been a lot of problems because we are not getting 100% connected with the patient. So in 28.6, we have again taken to repeat the CBC, where the CRP, C-reactive protein has came down to the brain after pulsatile and lymphocyte also increased a little bit, but WBC again goes up. If this is the happening in the case, then you have to understand that something is wrong, because the WBC is the fighting capacity. Even if C-reactive protein has gone down, but WBC is going down, it is the bad sign. So we ask, what is the patient condition? Part is gradual weakness, decreased appetite, heaviness in chest, difficulty in breathing, with slight exertion, light talking. Operation feeling in the chest in the night. She's saying, I have felt that my chest is got a lot of tightness in the chest and she feels she cannot breathe. So she is not able to sleep. General thought process, she is forcefully eating and prefers the sweet. Her daughter is saying she is only asking the sweet thing, not eating any spicy or anything. On that day, the saturation goes to 85 to 90. The medicine has given lycopodium. After this medicine, we repeat the CBC, where WBC started increasing 3100, neutrophil 66, but lymphocyte started going down. Now, this is the lymphopenia case, and where CRP is again there. We'll observe what is the patient's condition, same as before. Incident on that time, that she has mentioned that before we start care, she had fight with her neighbor, but she felt and she has felt that she will not get support from her husband. She has done and stand fight alone. On observation and video call done on that day, patient was wearing sweater. When asking, she said it's an early morning, it is cold over here. She gives the time on medium visit. No visible peak as her attention around the daily household work. So she is continuously what is going on in the home, what is doing in the farm. She is taking care of all. So on that basis, we have given a calculator of 10 dose. The calculator given because in she is an old patient, that time she is adenomyosis of the uterus, and calculator 400 has worked extraordinary in that case. So we see that this picture also matching the calculator, like taking care of the family. She is feel that she is not getting support. So this is the calcium. Actually calculator 10 has given. After calculator 10, the follow up has after 8 hours breathlessness is better. Saturation is improved from 85 to 90 on deep breathing. Clinical findings, the WBC has gone increasing, 4,500. HB is 10.4 and CRP is increased. Now, the CRP is the product of interleukin, IL-6, any inflammatory mediator, first in the blood, as we see in our last lecture of Sarna series, 18 lecture, we have studied the cell and cell pathology. In that lecture, we have explained to you what is CRP, what is interleukin, and how interleukin, the effect of interleukin will come on the CRP. Now, the patient WBC is increasing, HB is 10, clinically, patient feel better, but CRP is rising. On day 4, I have OPD in the room. When I go over there, I see the patient, but I don't. Patient is saying, I am better compared to previous, the breathlessness is decreased, but her look is not that good what we want. So we understand that something is wrong and something is not being here, even if the constitutional remedy has been said. So we ask, we force her to tell what has exactly has happened. So when you tell that thing, so we will able to help you out in the case. So initially she is not telling the thing. Breathlessness is still there. In saturation 85 also, she is sitting in front of me, waiting outside in the clinic, and she is comfortable. But her look is not good. So after forcing and after telling her, she has given this information to us. Before all this has started, one morning when she went to her farm, she saw some boiled egg kit. She picked that up from that place and threw away. At home, someone told her that she should not have touched. It could have been jinxed. And by evening, she started the fever. She said she also thought someone must have done some black magic on her family. So in panic, she threw that thing. And she has that fright that she has touched that material. So something will happen to her. This is the history which has come after forcing her and she is not telling because she's. She said that you will not believe this because these superstitious things and doctor don't believe. General, she is hot only, thirsty with diarrhea in mouth after taking paracetamol, otherwise not much sweating, sleeplessness because of the cough and breathing difficulty. After calculating up, the fever has gone, the body has not showing the fever. But the CRP is high. That means the internal body is dependent going on, but just not increasing on the outer level. So this stage has teaches us. I have taken element from fright or fear of the fright still remaining and superstitious. There are two remedies is coming. One is opium and second is belladonna. Now the case has taken 10 to 12 days, so the option of belladonna has gone up because of the acute. In first 2-3 days, the belladonna action is extraordinary. But as the case has prolonged and it's lingering, so we thought of giving opium because this rubric, fear of fright still remaining, is I feel it's very much. So opium 1M, I don't have 10M on that time, so I prescribed the 1M dose and I said, tell me in the evening how you are. The follow talk is improved, breathlessness is much better, able to sleep and appetite is better. On examination, saturation comes 96. A clinical findings, we repeat the report after 4 to 5 days because she is better. She has hesitated to go and do the test again and again because already 3 to 4 days she has done the test. So after 3 to 4 days, we have retrieved the result. The HB is 9.6, WBC is 7600, which is now previously 4500. Neutrophil is 47, lymphocyte, which is going down to 20 days, which has increased to 42, and CRP, which is 62, come to the 6. Now, this is the case which has teaches us the many things. See how the things are not working properly. When you give the remedy, first time you give medicine, that medicine is active, medicine feel patient feel better. Then again you come with some symptoms, they are not better. So in the first case, we are not getting exact understanding of the case. In second way, when we prescribe the pharmaceutical remedy in the higher potency. Because, and Dr. Harman has mentioned the acute diseases are the explosion of your latent solar. So that's why in most of the acute cases, Dr. Vijayakar has also mentioned that the constitution if you prescribe in the higher potency, the patient feel better. So even if calcarea has also not taken care completely, it is only giving a shorter period relief and for long time. But patient is not feeling well, she is not happy, she is look is dull, like she is not well since last 2 to 3 months. And appetite is average and not improved. So we understand that this is not actual cure what Hanuman has want. Or Dr. Vijayakar sir says that this has to be exact cure. So we again go and understand. And in this case, we understand the cause of the why this has started. Sir always says that from where it has started, what is triggering which give to the disease. Like we born as a healthy, and if anything which is morbific agent, was Dr. Hanuman also mentioned, why your body is not wanted to be in the healthy state. So that means something in physical form, in mental form, or emotional form, which is there on you, which keeping you away from the health. So we have to understand this thinking, why this is not actually working. So if you go and understanding the case, because once you understand case and always touch with the case, you will go and find out the right remedy. And the right remedy for this case is the opium. And she completely better after opium and no problem. We can say this cure is the exact cure because we are not getting history in the first attempt. But yes, we have not left the case. We are continuously working on the case and we will get the result. This is the third case, which is the phone case. When one of my patient sisters, on phone they have told her sister is not well since 5 to 7 days. She had fever one day. After that there is no fever, only generalized weakness, decreased appetite and difficulty in breathing. HRCT is showing the nerve score 9/25. She has told the saturation of 165 and 175. I asked about the patient, how is her condition now? She said that she is not having any another symptom except difficulty in breathing, but that also not much now. Only weakness we can see after looking at that. Now if you listen these things on the phone, that saturation is going 65, 75, 85, first of all, better to say the patient if he is not better or he is not in the condition to breathe, tell them to go and admit first. I also advise this patient, but they said she is not that bad, so we don't want to admit. They are hesitant to go and admit the patient. So we will take the simply this case. What you understand from this case? The disease is there, suddenness is there, and patient is having no complaint for this. Normally your saturation when goes, normal saturation is 98-99. When it stretches to the 90 or so, we started feeling breathless. If you cross the 80, below 80, you will feel breathless like you see in the previous case, difficulty in talking also. But once it goes to the 65-70, less than 75, you cannot lie down. You have to stay. But patient is not having this complaint. This is in the clinical term, we call it the happy hypoxia also. But for us, it's very important, painlessness for painful. So we've taken this and we prescribe the opium. I told her to take opium 10 dose and inform me after 12 hours. The follow after 24 hours, they say saturation is 92. Next day it is 99. Patient started eating within next 24 hours and no weakness and nothing. This is the three cases what we have studied or understand today. There are different approaches in these three cases. Even if we prescribe the opium, but the entry point of the opium has different. That's why it's very important that we study the trimethylmethyl mantramedica. Because in trimethylmethyl mantramedica, we understand the according to Maya fashion, according to Maya and the rubrics. Okay, so even if we give the same medicine for the same disease, but the entry point has to be different, and that entry point has to be the patient's need. So when you fulfill that need, automatically the disease will be taken care. So these are the three cases. And for the second case, Dr. Halimullah already mentioned in aphorism number 20. The spirit-like power to alter man's state of health, which lies hidden in the inner nature of the medicine, can itself never be discovered by us by a mere effort of reason. It is only by experience of the phenomenon it displays when acting on the state of the health of man that we can become clearly cognizant of it. Master Hanuman mentioned that cure or the 100% betterment of the patient, it is only by the experience of the phenomenon. So when we see the every case, where the every case is opportunity for us to give them to the cure as early as possible and as it is termed. As the physician is highly higher only mission to cure, restore as it is, which is mentioned by Dr. Hanuman. So this is the phenomenon. Once you give the remedy, you see the change. After that you again see, oh my god, this is not working well, this is not going to the right direction what sir has explained to us, and then we again see, okay, we have missed something, they have not told to us something. But in all these things, we should be always our attentive senses and in the logical reasoning. These two things will give us to the give a right remedy and help out the patient. Now let's be study the opium. As we know, all opium as a drug remedy, but it contains around the 17 or 18 alkaloids and two neutral substances as well as peculiar acid, that is meconic acid, of which apomorphine, morphine, codeine are well known. So the opium is not, it has contained of all this, but the apomorphine, morphine and codeine, these all things are used as a pain, decrease for pain. Okay. When we see a target organ, so every remedy or every drug has its own peculiar action, as every person has its own way of living, way of understanding, way of taking and way of reacting. So every drug has its own peculiar action on the particular organs or particular, so we have to understand where this medicine is got or more affection. So it is helping us to understand the remedy. Let's understand our target organs, senses. So all senses, nerves. In nerves, it's mainly a brain, cerebrospinal, and sympathetic, lungs and respiration, digestive tract. It is mentioned that opium exerts irritability and activity of voluntary muscles and inactivity of involuntary muscles. So if you see those who have opium poisoning or those has taken opium for as a drug, so you will say this is a excitability, an activity of voluntary muscle, but gradual inactivity of the involuntary muscle. In old books, it has mentioned previously opium used as acute peritonitis. Now, how it will help in acute peritonitis? That the it is acting on involuntary on the inactivity on the involuntary muscle. So your peristalsis is involuntary, which is not in your control. So in the old days, they have given opium dose of peritonitis. So once you take the opium, there is no activity of your intestine. And if there is no activity, inflammation will settle within 2 to 3 days and patient will get better. So that is the prescription in old era. Now the position somewhere we get that this remedy has got because of that this exaggerated the symptoms. The first of all, it's fear, fright, embarrassment, sudden joy and charcoal fumes. Now suddenly, if the person is not very happy, suddenly he get a good news and he is not able to take that thing, then also it produces symptom. It mostly a very few remedies is from element from joy. The another one is the popular. Let me understand this, how the sir has teaches us opium in sora, physical and mental. So you will see in physical there are things which can visible to your eyes or cognizant to it, and one thing is mental, which is only observed by the senses or by the person. So in physical there is hyperactivity, itching on the skin. On the mental level, activity in general, cheerfulness, brain joyous and pleasant. In psychosis, there is slowness in peristalsis, constipation, process of eyelid, proximal condition of the body. On mental level, there is a fixed idea, imbecility, irritation, liar, topper, courageous, shameless and suspicious. Amorous. Last, in syphilis, a physical level, painlessness. That is a syphilitic symptom because everyone, if someone feels to someone, it has to feel the pain. If it is not, that means it is syphilitic. Complaints of nothing, that we see in the case of third case, trembling and twitching, comatose unconsciousness, and stupor. In the mental level, unconsciousness, heedless, careless, mania, muttering, extravagance. Now, this we understand opium in the three different states. See how opium in the sora, what is the symptom of opium in physical and mental, what is the symptom of the opium in psychotic physical level and the mental level, and what is the symptom of opium in syphilis on the physical level and mental level. Now this study has given us a clear cut understanding of the opium's actions, from where the opium is acting and what level it is at. Basically, what we learn from the Matramatica, the opium, the main action upon the susceptibility. Okay, a person when they have want of susceptibility, whenever we give the remedy or the correct remedy and patient is not responding to that remedy, on that time also opium is very important, very useful. You prescribe to opium, the susceptibility get around and then the patient in the path of the cure. So there also we think of the opium when it is extraordinarily good result. Another thing of opium which is very important, where we understand what exactly exaggeration, exaltation, hyperactivity, restlessness, all these are the opium's basic symptoms where we understand. This is the soric psychotic symptom, and in syphilitic we will go on stuporous condition, eyes turning upwards, twitching, sober, non-coughing, torpor state, all these also come under the opium only. So this is the Matra Medica where we understand this is the one phase, which is the sora, second is the psychotic, and third is the syphilitic. In sora, we will see the excitement, we will see the jolliness, we will see the hyperactivity. In psychotic, we will see a dumbness, slowness. In the physical level, on the mental level, there is a domination, dominating. Okay. And in the syphilis, we have to see a different part where everyone knows about the opium. So when we study the opium from different books also, over there it has mentioned that in the most of the end of the cases where the patient is not responding, not acting, the stertorous breathing is there, on that time also opium is very useful. But once the symptom has to be met, and for that we have to understand this trimiasmatic presentation of the Matra Medica. There is another case which is written, I think Clark, that it has mentioned that they have given the opium to the pregnant female. Where in a pregnant female, what happens? The contraction, the labor pain, the female has to be forced to expel the baby out. So when the baby is not coming out, when the activity of the baby is less, on that time also they give the opium doses, and then the expulsion of the fetus come out. Or when the baby has born, or they have the aspiration neonatrum or stertorous breathing, baby's luminous color, all that thing, on that time also they give the opium to take care. This is understanding about the opium in trimiasmatic Matra Medica, and this is the way that we understand. Okay, this is the one part, this is the second, and this is the third. So when you see the cases, when you see the patients, when you talk with the patients, as they have said, the senses has to be active. So you will categorize the case. Okay, this is the solid case, this is the psychotic case, and this is the syphilitic case. Now how, what you have to take this? Every patient has presented all three miasms, or two miasms, or one miasm. But what has to be taken and what not has to be taken, that is very important. For this, dominant miasm of the person has to be taken in consideration. Now, what is a dominant miasm? If there a child or any person can born with the sora, psychosis, or syphilis, this is a sir says always that if the person start born with the sora, grows with the psychosis, then psychosis is goes with the syphilis. Okay, as the age goes, as the incidence happens to himself or his own constitution, he behaves according to that. But when the person born with the psychotic, you will have the most of the psychotic symptom, which is predominant. And then the sora, then again psychotic and psychosyphilitic case you will find out. Where we always see the person will have diabetes, blood pressure, all these complaints which is lingering. Because it is born psychotic and patient is always deceitful, liar, don't want to work, want to relax, want things very easily. That is the psychotic. When the person has born with the syphilis, once someone born with the syphilis, they already have the syphilitic symptoms. And from the syphilis, it again comes with the flora, psychotic and syphilitic. So that is called as syphilosoric, syphilopsychotic, and syphilosyphilitic. Okay, like the congenital anomaly in the children, this come under syphilosyphilitic case, where there is a destruction of the normal growth of the organs. This is the youth where we will not miss out anything in the case, and we will pick up what is dominant. The sir always says, or analog also always mentioned, PQRS symptom, which is peculiar, pure, rare and strange symptom in each and every patient. Patient will tell us or you will observe us. This is only two things, or attendant will tell us. This is three things where you can take the PQRS and you can match. Like if the sir always says, if it is a psychotic case, And if you take the cypertextual term, you will not able to help out the case. Because Cypress is already it is a facade. So on that time you have to go and see the basic nature, that is the story, or any syphilitic there. That is syphilitic means it's growing and soaring means it's base. So according to that we will consider that in the case and give more importance to that and give the right remedy. Let's move ahead to the another remedy. Apis mellifica. Now Apis mellifica, everyone knows it's bee. Once anyone gets bee sting, you will have the symptoms of what is the basic symptom? You will get burning, stinging, stitching, redness, inflammation, swelling, all these are the symptoms. So there are other cases, if you study the Metranetica, if you read all Talbot's books, they have beautifully mentioned the ways how it action upon the human being. So patient will start with the burnings first, smarting pain, restlessness, can't sit at one place. This is because of after this poison enter into the body, it gives inflammatory reaction. And because of inflammatory reaction, it will show all signs of inflammation. Pallor, pupal, pallor, functional level. Tumor. Okay, so this is the Apis mellifica. Now when Apis mellifica proven on the human being, what is the symptoms which has tell you go over to the symptoms are recorded. First we understand that where the action of this medicine. Basically this medicine has good action on the cellular tissue, that is eyes, face, horses and ovaries. Serous cavities, skin, respiration, heart, blood, kidney and bladder. So these are the organs where the sphere of action is there. Now you will see the cellular tissue and serous cavities. Basically, Apis has most of the action upon the coverings, okay, on the skin or internal organ covering. So it is pericardium, peritonitis. Over there, it has the those who have covering and has some fluid inside, a serous inside. So inflammation of that serous is very marked in Apis mellifica. What is the causation of it or element form of it? For jealousy, fright, rage and vexation. Badness. Now we understand this as we understand the opium also. In the three, sora psychotic syphilis, physical level and mental level. Let's go through the slides. In physical, in sora, physical level, we'll see inflammation, sensitive to external inflammation or the stimulus. That's why they have aggravation from touch. They don't want any touch from hard also and soft also. And congestion. Congestion because of the increased blood supply to that area. On the mental level, you will see they're very irritable, industrious, acute senses. And sensitive to all external impression. Now this is exactly a matching of this is the result of this. The physical, your expressions or what I am talking now, what I am telling to you, this all things is my what is in my mind. So you always have to match. Sir always says what is inside it has to be on the outside. It is the mirror image. It is not a different thing. So, if you see, sensitive to all external inflammation is come to the sensitive to external stimulus. Also, irritability easily because of the inflammation. In psychosis, we have edema. Swelling, hardness of covering ligaments and gland, invalidations, retention of urine, cellulitis and thrombosis. This we see on the physical level symptom. Now, edema, accumulation of thing, swelling is thickening, hardness, hardness has given the contractions. Because of the contractions of the fibers, it causes the hardness. So coverings, ligaments and gland, so you will get the joint stiffness and everything. In duration, again, hardness, retention of urine, the accumulation, cellulitis. Now this cellulitis and inflammation. This is cellulitis is general level. When the blood got get poisoned, that's why it's come under the psychotic. And thrombosis, that is formation of the clot. So the same thing we see on the mental level, what is the psychotic symptom of this? Anguish, busy, very busy. As you see neighbor, week is always continuously not sit at one place. So they are very busy, dictatorial, jealous, obstinate and discontent. All these rubrics are the psychotic. And last one is the syphilis, that is on the physical level. On mental level, let's see what is the syphilitic symptoms. Perforation, abortion, renal failure, ulcer, discharge of putrid, and septic. Now these all are syphilitic physicals, but perforation where something is inserted into another or broke up thing. Abortion is discontinuing of the life. Renal failure, where you are basic, the kidney has the first organ which forms into the body. So when anything which got formed, it has to be excreted out. So when the excretion is what failure, that means there is a syphilis. Because of this failure, third, ulcer formation, rodent ulcer, deep ulcer, non-healing ulcer, all these come under the syphilis. Often putrid discharges, like the discharges having the cadaverous smell, that is also goes to the syphilis. And septic fever, the fever which is not taking care, as you see our case number 2, where the patient will having the continuous fever, the high grade fever, which is, sorry, in the case number 1, the patient is having continuous fever, patient is not better, no gap in the fever, that is the septic fever, but that fever has to be more than 5 to 7 days, so the whole body has got inflamed and blood poisoning has got occurred. Now, in the mental level, you will understand their presentment of insanity, madness, awkwardness, fruitlessly busy, shaking, brain dry, psychogenesis, and stupor. Now, what is death presentment of? It's not death desire, it's not suicidal disposition. Sir has mentioned, this. Death presentment, that means you are not want, you want to go to death. Okay, you don't have any decision. But there is a state when you start feeling that death is coming near to you. This is called a death presentment of insanity, madness, awkwardness, fruitlessly busy. These are symptoms of awkwardness, that means you are not attentive, or you are buried in thoughts where you are not seeing the thing. That is awkwardness. Shaking, brain dry. This will come into the hypersensitivity condition, inflammation of the brain, where we get these all symptoms. The child is continuously crying. Child cannot sit at one place only. See, the child will cry day and night and shaking, screaming. This is called as the irritation of the brain. Satyriasis, abnormal sexual desire, and stuporous condition. This is basically the stuporous condition we see in the end diseases or in the cancerous patient, where the patient has multi organ failure, multi organ affection, or in the patient having the brain complaint, as well as the lesion, where the automatically the multi organs start getting affected, which give rise to the stertorous breathing, drowsiness, stupor. There is a looseness between life and the death. The patient lies in between that, that is a stuporous condition. But you see he is alive, he is happy to be, but he is not in the senses to react. He is not in senses to take the thing. He is between the for the indigenous superlux solution. In the mathematical language, there are many remedies in the superlux solution, and OPM and ethics are 3+. This will understand the habis magnifica as all three levels. Let's see. In epics, as the drug picture is mentioned, or another author has mentioned, we will understand in epics medifica first is the inflammation, stinging, edema, swelling, accumulation, and kidney affection. This all has a PQRS in the mark symptom of the epics medifica. But at the same time, the psychotic epics medifica will say they are very industrious, they are very dominating, they are jealous, and they are very ambitious. So they want things according to them. So that's why they all will come onto the psychotic conditions. We will understand other things. Dr. Hanneman mentioned in aphorism number 9, it is very evident that medicine could never cure the disease if they did not possess the power of alternating man's state of health, which depends on sensation and function. So Dr. Hanneman, even in episode number 19, says, it is very evident that medicine could never cure the disease. If we want to take care of the patient, we want to do the right remedy. So we have to understand this, that medicine will never attain if they did not possess the power of alternating man's state health, which depends on the sensations and the function. So, if I am having some symptoms or I am having some disease, I will throw some symptoms on the mental level, on the physical level. That both things when we combine will say this is the disease state. And that disease state because of the personality or maybe some desires or anything. So this will give rise. Why I am telling this at this point, the reason is the sensations and functions of persons in the healthy condition, sensation of the functions in the psychotic condition, and sensation and the function in the schizophrenic condition. All three conditions, it is different. If you see as a child, if you see as a married man or middle age group, and if you see it's an old age person, they all have, all children have some peculiar symptoms. That is the child symptom, or age, middle age have their own peculiar understanding. That is the middle age group and the old age. So if you think, if you try to understand the person, you have to cut out the what is common. Like a child has to be a playful. If it is not playful, that is abnormal. You have to consider why that child is not playing. Okay. In middle age, they all should have that responsibility, and responsible to take care of self, take care of family and everything. That is the normal basic thing in the psychotic manner. So they have to be growth, accumulate the things for themselves, for the future. So this is understanding of the psychotic condition. Now, in the schizophrenic condition, I went from alone, no one is for me, I wife or husband get expired, so they alone, they are in different state. So this is schizophrenic. So this is all in the mental level. If you see the physical level of the symptom in the flora, in the psychotic and the schizophrenic, it is different. Or physical appearance also different. Most of the middle age, if you see a healthy grade, either it is healthy or either it is very limited. Because a psychosis is the two part, as we explained in the last lecture, it is the hyperpsychosis or the hypopsychosis. So a person is very thin or a person is obese. In the old age, you will always see there are lean thin, loss of muscles, emaciation, which is many more. This is also goes into the schizophrenic state. Now in the Sora, we'll see our baby is always happy, children are playful, cracking joke, mischievousness, intellectually their learning ability is very good. They want to understand things very fast. They pick up the thing very fast. So all this come is a learning. So anything comes which is in the learning form, the growing form in the Sora. So as a man evolves, he's evolved from Sora to Cyclosis, from Cyclosis to the Cephalus. So that's why Hanuman has always, Dr. Hanuman has always mentioned that you have to understand all these things, how to differentiate these things, and then we can able to pick up what we need. That's why it's always mentioned the discovery of homeopathy. Discovery of Mayadam is much more important than discovery of homeopathy. Because after the discovery of Mayadam has occurred, or understanding of Mayadam has come into the picture, the actual true value of homeopathy has risen. And this because we can cure the incurable diseases. So sir always says the scope is always in homeopathy and not in homeopathy, and there is no limitations. If your senses is active, if you are alert, if you are taking care of the, if you have will to give the result, if you have will to do a goodness with the humanity, and that will help you to take care of the patient. And it is not my own, it's mentioned by Dr. Hanuman in one aphorism. It is aphorism number 14. Dr. Hanuman has mentioned, this is in the interior of the man, nothing morbid that is curable and no visible morbid alteration that is curable, which does not take itself known to the accurately observing physician by means of the morbid sign and symptoms, and in perfect conformity with infinite goodness of all the wise reservoir of human life. So, aphorism number 14, they have already mentioned this. It is with the infinite goodness of the all wise reservoir of human life. So, once as a physician, as a homeopath, once you have, as a doctor, if you know that the person is suffering and they have come to us to free from the suffering, with your goodness and the all wise preserver, you will always take care of them. So there is no limitations. A limitation lies in our understanding and our senses, which is unable to pick up the things. And this we see when we are with the sir, that we, when we assisting sir in the initial day, we have to a lot of experiences of all this time. Like we take the case over 1 hour, 1.5 hour, and we go to the sir and sir says, okay, take it. This is the reference. We astonish on the topic, what is happening? So once the experience, once you evolve, once you have a blessing and you gradually grow. So this is a journey where we actually understand what happened. So understanding of the trial mathematic matrimonial is very important when you understand the trial three mayasms of the person and from which mayasm the person is belongs, whether it is a psychotic, whether it is syphilitic, or whether it is so. Once you understand this, you will actually understand that that person, and once you understand the person, you know what is the cause of that, you know what the element from that, and according to that, we can able to help you more. Okay, so we conclude here the lecture. Thank you. Thank you.